Hey friends, what's up? I just got here to ride now Power Sports and sweating already. But let's see who's here. Today's Friday, around 10:30 in the morning. So I think this is going to be quite busy on Saturday. That's why I came today. I just wanted to avoid the crowds. Let's see what they have on offer. I've already ridden the K1600, the R18. I'd really like to ride the Double R. So here's all the bikes on offer today. K1600 Bagger, got an R18. R18 with, I forget what they call that one.
Oh, sorry, Jed.
Got an RT. XR. Some GSs, the different variants. The variants of GS. S1000R. GSs, there's the one I rode, the Double R. There's the M naked version. Very sick looking bike. GS, RS, more GSs, different configurations, 850, 1250, etc. And the F900, another K1600. Everyone enjoying themselves at the tent. I'm going to be riding this one. This will be fun to see what this feels like on my back. But the BMW rep said I'm going to be surprised on how comfortable it is. So we shall see. Okay, well, hopefully you can hear me. It's got a lot of wind blowing on me. I'm leaned way forward. It feels like I'm in the bike. The bike is under me. I can't, if I'm looking straight ahead, I can't even see my dashboard, my TFT. This is definitely a different riding position. And it's it's higher than my RS, especially with my Sergeant seat now. Yeah, I'm kind of tippy-toeing. So I got a guy here in front of me is riding an RS. Wow, I'm just using the quick shifter now. It's so smooth compared to the RS. Very, very smooth. And I'm very surprised. The only time I'm really putting a lot of pressure on my wrist is when I'm stopped like this, because I'm on my tippy toes. When we're riding, the bulk of my weight is on my legs and my butt. So it's quite comfortable. So this is it, S1000RR. I'm getting a lot of heat by my inner thighs though that I don't have on the RS, because this is an inline four. The downshifting, quick shifter, upshifting, smooth, very smooth. Oh great, green light, let's go. Right away, this does not have nearly as much torque as the RS in terms of like when you hit the throttle. The RS really pulls you and you can feel it, but this definitely cracks right, you know, as soon as you get the RPMs up a little bit.
it's gonna want to fly, and it would just, you know, devastate a RS in the long run. Yeah, when I'm riding this, it's very comfortable.
I'm gonna put it in dynamic mode. It was in road mode. Very easy to find neutral.
The quick shifter is just amazing. I think the two things that have surprised me so far is the quick shifter, how smooth it is, and the fact that I don't really feel much pressure on my wrist when I'm riding, because I'm hugging the tank with my legs, putting a lot of my weight into my, you know, legs and butt. Oh no, we're behind a bus. Yeah, once you're up in the higher RPMs and you hit the throttle, this bike wants to fly. Yeah, I don't think I could ride this for like hours on end, but the ride escort said this is going to be about a 25-30 minute ride, depending on how fast we go. I think I could easily ride this for an hour and a half without my back seizing up. I love the shifter on this. Can't say enough about that. I'm sure other sport bikes have very nice quick shifters too, but coming from an RS, the shifter is quite clunky. I'm used to it, but this is very fun.
Got some carbon fiber. This is the performance package, I believe. The racing colors. Cool bike. Hello. Yeah, this is the boxer engine, of course, sticks out and gets both cylinder heads are in the wind. So it gets a lot of cooling as you ride, and it is air and liquid cooled DRS, so it's a much cooler engine. Right now I feel heat coming up big time, up into my inner thighs.
Another thing I can say about this bike is, even I'm getting hit with the wind right in my chest. So I'm thinking my audio should be pretty clean, because I'm not feeling or hearing any helmet buffeting like I do on my RS. So that's another plus. My helmet feels nice and clear. I don't even have my earplugs in, and I don't even need to consider wearing them, really, to be honest. But the RS, I have to. There's too much buffeting. This is definitely a fun bike, and some interesting things I'm learning.
Yeah, I think the thing I don't like about this bike is the stopping, because it is incredibly hot and humid, and that sucks, but it's not the bike's fault. And the the hands on the handlebars, it's just a lot of weight when you stand up to put on your wrist. So I'm getting in the habit of putting it in neutral at the stoplight and then standing up and getting my hands off those grips.
Suspension wise, we haven't really hit any big bumps, but it feels pretty good. It's a little stiff, as it should be for a sport bike, but yeah, I'm liking this. My wrists feel fine. We're going over some little bumps right now, and my RS is definitely smoother than this. But it's still not terrible by any means. Jerry, we're coming up to the end of our ride here, and I gotta say, I had a lot of fun on this. Learned some things, quick shifter and body position, and how the TFT in the front of the bike, the dash, just kind of disappears under my chin guard. I can't really see it. I thought this was a little shorter. I thought the seat wouldn't be as high as it is.
But it is. It's not a problem, though. I'm 5'8". What else? The quick shifter, yeah, I can't say enough about that. Just coming from an RS, or if you've got a bike that's got a clunky quick shifter, excuse me, I'm burping, disgusting. I drank like 3 liters of water while we were waiting for this. It just, when you go from something you're so used to that's, you know, not the greatest, and then you have something that's like, hey, this is how it's supposed to work, that's cool. Seating position, and just, you know, riding it with my legs and my feet and my butt, all my weight, my wrists are not, I thought my wrists were going to be screaming on this thing, but the only time that happens is when I stop like this. And it's not excruciating. My back feels fine.
I do have a back issue. I am 55 years old after all. I think everyone has, you hit over 40 and something happens and you're like, you get dad back, I guess. My back feels fine. So here we are back at home.
Yum, 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 yum. And this is the next bike I'm gonna ride. RT and police motorcycle. Again, I unfortunately ran out of battery power on my GoPro, so for now it's got the same boxer engine as my bike. It's heavier, bigger fairing, larger TFT. A lot more doodads for touring and longer distance. More upright position, heated seat. These are preload buttons, I believe. You can program them to do certain things. Ouch, that is extremely hot. These things are just baking in the sun. Yeah, these here you can program to do different things. I think this might have the adaptive cruise control, but I know that somebody, oh, maybe this is it here, I think. Up is I'm gonna ride this XR right here. This S1000 XR has a similar motor to the Double R, inline four, but it's got a seating position more like a GS, so should be fun.
All right, folks, that's it. I just got off the S1000 XR. It was a lot of fun. It was kind of like riding a Double R in the configuration of a GS. So you're sitting, you know, mid control, sitting upright, nice high pull back handlebars, very comfortable. I could ride that for a long time without getting tired. And it's got the peppy, from what I understand, it's got the older Double R motor in it. So it's basically got a race motor in it, probably 180 horsepower or something like that. I don't know. The new one, there's supposed to be a new M version come out. It's got 200 something horsepower. So as far as the zip, it's similar to the Double R. You get on it and it just kind of gently puts you into hyperspace compared to my RS, which is, you know, a tractor and just yanks you immediately into some quick speed, and then it kind of levels off after that. But that's it from Ride Now. Where's the sign? Ride Now Power Sports Austin. I think the BMW Motorrad truck is going to some other places in Texas and around the country. From what I understand, they have two trucks. I'll see if I can get the dates and I'll put them up right here and you can check them out. Go ride some bikes. All right, have fun, be safe, later.